बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट माइकल फुकॉल्ट एंड सीडीए क्रिटिकल डिस्कोर्स एनालिसिस। दैट व्हाट आर द व्यूज ऑफ माइकल फुकॉल्ट अबाउट क्रिटिकल डिस्कोर्स एनालिसिस एंड व्हाट आर द इनिशियल स्टेजेस आर फेजेस व्हिच आर बीइंग टू फॉलो इन द क्रिटिकल डिस्कोर्स एनालिसिस। व्हाट आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेप्स टू फॉलो इन द क्रिटिकल डिस्कोर्स एनालिसिस। So what Michael Foucault says about CDA. So Michael Foucault was a French philosopher, historian, and social theorist. He wrote about the social theories, critics, social criticism, and he discussed that all these things are being existed in the shape of power. So power and knowledge are two most important factors which are existed in a society, and it affect society ideology, discourse in each and everything. So he addresses the relationship between power and knowledge and how they are used as a form of social control through societal institution, though often cited as a post-structuralist and post-modernist. So Foucault rejected these levels, and he thought has influenced academic, especially those working. So he was affected by social communication studies, anthropology, sociology. So all these things are very related to the society, and society in a society, knowledge and power are existed, and how these two factors affect a society, and how people used to get follow the ideology of person or a group of person in the form of power and knowledge. So in short, he says that there are two things, power and knowledge, through which a person or a group of people control get the control of society, and they control emotions of a person or a group of people. He discusses two most important things. The first one is power. So what is power? Power in social and political view. So in social science and politics, power is the capacity of an individual to influence the action, belief, or conduct of other. So it is, as I told you, that it doesn't mean to teach someone, it doesn't mean to force someone and get respect from someone. So it is in the form of ideology, it is the form of leadership, that how a person, how a group of people go forward, and they used to some group of people, a society, to follow that particular person or a group of people. So he says that the use of power need not involve force or threat. Force, so power doesn't mean that the person, a particular person, use some kinds of threats, some kinds of force to being followed by the people or a group of people. So an example of using force without oppression is the concept of soft power as compared to hard power. So soft power and hard power mean that people are being used to be followed and give respect to that particular person who have strong discourse, and strong discourse due to a kind of ideology. Like recently, that people followed a group of people that is known as BTI because of a slogan, and their slogan is known as a Tabdili. So the word Tabdili has a power and to use and to be followed by a group of people or a nation. And power is given to a person or a group of people by the willingness of body or the support of people. And if the people support a group of people or a person, so the person came in a power, and he or she has the ideology. So Foucault claims that the modern representation of power began as a mode of inquiry to answer specific questions about how to control people in certain specific situations. So the most important thing that power is get is guarded by some kind of people or a person that how to control people. So for that, a person needs to think to get a kind of idea. So that idea, we give the name of ideology in certain and specific situation. Like you know that some people have political ideology, some people have religious ideology, social ideology. So the mixture of all these things are being used to get the power, and people are being used to follow them. And second thing is knowledge. Knowledge means that a certain knowledge about certain belief, ideology, like we can say that skills, activities that a person or a people knew how and what to apply in what situation. So that is known as knowledge. Foucauldian discourse analysis means that how discourse analysis are being used by Foucault, and what kind of thing he used to say in the discourse analysis. So he says that power relationship in a society as expressed through language and practices. So how power is guarded by a person or a particular group of people, so it is the using of knowledge, the using of language. So the particular using of vocabulary and terminology, so they catch the attention of the people, they catch the emotion of the people, and so the people use to follow a person, and that social practice is being given the name of power. So the discourse analysis of Foucault is stress on the power relationship. So how, what does mean of power relationship? Power relationship mean that there will be two kind of people or two kinds of group. So one person will be a leader and the second person will be the follower. So there will be power relationship. And how a person get the power? So power is being given to the person by a person or a group of people because of the using of language and social practices. So as it has been mentioned in the lines, that there are expressed through language and behavior and the relationship between language and power. So this form of analysis developed out of Foucault genealogical work, mean it has been coming from the very old days, that where power was linked to the formation of discourse within specific historical period. So the genealogical application of discourse analysis to illustrate how discourse is produced to govern social group. So people firstly study and they do analysis of a group of people, that how we have to control the society and the emotion of a group of people, and how they will get power in a particular situation. So for that purpose, they develop a kind of discourse, and their discourse is being dependent on the power, and the power is being got by through the use of language and our discursive practice. So as I told you that the approach of Michael Foucault was very social. So he it is very close to social constructivism. So social constructivism means that it is a sociological theory of knowledge according to which human development is socially situated, and knowledge is constructed through interaction with other. So the social constructivism is being got from the from being the following of the people, and how our society is being shaped or constructed by language. So it is the use of language that we establish a kind of particular kind of ideology, and that ideology we follow, that ideology in our daily communication, and we we used to talk according to that ideology, and we use terminology, vocabulary according to that concept which has been shaped or constructed in our society by a group of people. And so some people give different name to different ideology, like, as I told you, social ideology, religious ideology, cultural ideology. So there are too many things which are being used in ideology, which is turn and reflect existing power relationship, and there should be the use of power will be existed in the social constructivism, or the using of power in a society. So it has been taken from political oriented studies, and it means that political power is gained by those in power be more knowledgeable and therefore more legitimate in exercising their control over other in both blatant and invisible ways. So the people use to get some kinds of ideas or ideologies, and they use the knowledge, the vocabulary and the language according to that ideology forward to control on to control the emotions and the thoughts of the people or the group of people. How a person get power in a society. So there are four steps that how those statements are created. Statement mean a kind of language. So what can be said, what and what cannot be. So how spaces in which new statement can be made are created, making practices material and discursive at the same time. So these are four points which are necessary to get power in a society, and people use to follow you or a group of people. So Foucault discourse analysis might look at how figures in authority use language to express their dominance. So they use a kind of language forward the purpose of using a particular language to get dominance in a society, and request obedience and respect from the subordinate to them. So it is the use of language that people give respect to them, and the disciplinary interaction between authority and their follower emphasizes the power dynamic found within the relationship, and that relationship is being based on the power, and they get the power through the language, and that language is being produced through according to the ideology. So Foucault says that the discourse analysis is based on the power, and those people will get power who have particular language, particular knowledge of that particular group of people to whom the person want to be to do go on and to get some kind of being fellowship or being followed by the group of people.